Looking at the Agenda 2030, we have 12 years to go, and not a single country is on track to achieve the SDG goals. What has to be done better?
Indeed, it is alarming that our report this year shows that although many countries say that they want to achieve the SDGs, hardly make progress. So what has to be done is not only pay lip service to the SDGs, but also to implement them. This is to include them in the machinery of the government, in the action plans, in the budget cycle, in the programs of the institutions, etc. So this is the normal way to implement political goals, and it has to be done. And it has to be done now, because already 20% of our time is consumed. Reports like these are necessary for two reasons. Number one, to alarm and to make aware that something has to be done. And number two, a report like this also challenges academia and other actors also to think about what could be the solutions, how to reach the goals, where sometimes it's very difficult. It's not easy to achieve all the goals when it comes to education or health or infrastructure or clean energy or the environment. And there is also a lot of thinking has to be done in order to find the right solutions.
The report stresses the necessity for countries to work together. How hard is it to reach that goal if you have one country, a major player, who basically decides to go it alone?
Well, one country alone cannot stop others from acting to strive and to achieve the SDGs. But on the other hand, it's also true that one country alone cannot achieve the SDGs. So multilateral cooperation is necessary. And there we see that some countries stand very firm for the case of multilateral agreements, like countries like Canada, like France, like others. And also some countries tend to be more interested in purely national interest-driven deals. And what is important to reach the SDGs is that those countries who are in favor of multilateralism find a way to cooperate and get their act together, and then sooner or later we hope that we all get on the same track.
If we stick to the traffic lights format, where is the red light actually flashing, because it's such an urgent problem from your point of view, and where does a green light give you actual hope?
Yeah, well, the red light that is flashing is that's everything that has to do with climate change and with biodiversity in particular, because these are developments that are irreversible. So if we cannot stop the reduction of biodiversity, and if we cannot stop climate change, then everything that happens in between is really lost. When it comes to the green light, we see that there is continuous progress in the eradication of poverty, although I have to say that today's technical changes and also globalizations comes with a lot of winners and losers. But fortunately, in general, the number of people that live in poverty is developing in the right direction.